Hi, today's October the 5th, 2020. This is Dr. Fryer, and in this screencast, I'd like to show you how you can add some audio narration to a Scratch dialogue project, which you've made that uses speech bubbles. So in this example, when I click the green flag, you're not only going to see speech bubbles, but you're also going to hear me narrating this dialogue.
¿Te gusta la basura?
Sí, por supuesto. Me gusta la basura mucho.
Okay, I'm going to click the stop button, and I want to go ahead and show you what I have added here to do this. So I'm going to click See Inside. The first step is to make sure that you click on the sprite where you want to add the narration. The narration is going to be added, or the sound file is going to be added to that actual sprite. And if you delete the sprite, you actually delete the narration. So this character, my green dragon, is saying two things. ¿Te gusta la basura? ¿Y dónde está Skedidio? Up here in the upper left corner, you see the code tab, and there's costumes where I can change the costume of my character, but number three is sounds, and then this is what we want here. So you can see right now I just have the first one, te gusta la basura. So I need to record another thing here for donde está Skididio, and I'm going to also use a block, which is magenta. It is a sound block. I'm not going to use the play sound until done. I'm going to start sound because I want the sound to play, and then I want the speech bubble right away to come up. And if I choose that first one until done, the speech bubble wouldn't come up until the audio is finished. So I'm ready to record here and say, ¿Dónde está Skididio? So I'm going to click on sounds. I'm going to go down here, and I got to move my picture over a little bit. Click on in the upper bottom left corner on choose a sound, but I'm not going to choose to search, which is the magnifying glass. I'm going to click on the second choice, which is record, and it looks like a microphone. So I'm going to click on that, and I'm going to click record and record my audio. ¿Dónde está Skididio? Now, notice that there is some blank space here in the beginning. ¿Dónde está Skididio? And I don't want to need to really keep that. And so I can drag this slider here to eliminate that audio. I can push play to see how it sounds. ¿Dónde está Skididio? And then I'm going to click save. Make sure you don't trim it too closely because you do want to hear the entire thing. But this is nice to be able to cut out some of the blank empty space that you may have either before you started to record or at the end. Now, I also recommend that you give it a name, and so I'm just going to say, ¿Dónde está? And that's going to help you when you get over here to your code. So, I'm now ready for my block that's going to play the sound. That's the start sound, and so I'm going to drag that out. And this is going to automatically put whatever the last thing was that I recorded. I think I probably need to do the same thing here, too. I didn't record, él está atrás de la puerta, which means he is outside the door. So let me record that really quick. Oop. And I click search instead. Be careful when you click this not to just click the first one. You want to click on the microphone. Él está atrás de la puerta. Same thing. I can drag this over. Save it. Él está atrás de la puerta. I'm going to say está atrás as a name. And then over here in my code, I'm ready to start that sound and have that happen right after my pause before my speech bubble comes up. So I think I'm all set. But you know what I see I did? I actually put this one in the wrong spot. And I would have found that out as I played it because I want it to wait until it responds. Make sure these times are aligned, and you may need to increase these. I'm using 4 seconds for all of mine, but if you have longer sentences, longer dialogue that takes more time, you may need to adjust that. So let's go full screen and see what this project sounds like now.
¿Te gusta la basura?
Sí, por supuesto. Me gusta la basura mucho.
¿Dónde está Skididio? Él está atrás de la puerta.
Okay, there you go. So that's the end of that project. So, hope that's helpful to you. Good luck. And I guess I should also say, When you're done, if you're in our Spanish class, I encourage you to go ahead and add this to our projects gallery. And when you go up to your Cassidy bookmarks, it's near the bottom, and it's the fifth grade Spanish projects gallery. And you'll be able to add that, and then other people will be able to see your project too. All right, good luck.